Michael Cera, bro. Best part of that movie, bro. Absolute best, bro.
Yeah, bro, I fuck with Michael Cera, bro. He's hard. He's hard as fuck.
Yo, it's kind of cold, bro. You got a jacket or a hoodie, something like that?
Should've wore a hoodie.
Bro, come on, bro, please. I know you're gonna drive with the windows open and everything too. Please, bro.
You should've wore a hoodie, bro.
Bro, come on. I know you got something for me, bro. Please. Please, bro, please. You got something for
me. Fine. I might have a jacket in the trunk.
Yeah, for real, sure. Isn't that the jacket from Drive? Bro, you gotta let me drive the whip, bro. You gotta let me. If you're gonna let me wear the jacket, I gotta drive the whip, bro. You
then
crazy?
I guess I gotta wear the jacket.
Nah, give me the jacket.
Maybe we should switch.
Nah, I'm driving, bro. I'm driving.
Yo, can we just go home, bro? I'm tired of this shit. Just wanna go home for the night.
Bro, I'm so high. You ready for this montage?
No, I'm not ready for this shit.
Yes, you are, bro. Alright, let's go. Bro, put your seatbelt on, bro, please.
Are you gonna go, bro?
I'm going. I want to drive you through the night, down the hills. I gotta tell you something you don't want to hear. I'm gonna show you where it's dark, but have no fear. There's something inside you. It's hard to explain. They're talking about you, boy, but you're still the same. All right, enough of that. I know a lot of you guys are like, where is the review? What is this? Why are we watching you drive? Yeah, there's a new thing I'm doing on this channel. So from now on, for movie reviews, I'm gonna try my best to put a little skit before the review that kind of relates to the movie. I don't want the painting to be too distracting. Let's go this way. I know Drive and Barbie, like, how does that correspond? It's because Ryan Gosling, okay? I use that as an excuse to do a Drive little sequence. But yeah, from now on, movie reviews are gonna have a skit that kind of relates to the review. That way I could just, you know, make the reviews a little bit more unique. I could practice my filmmaking and I could just share things that I think are creative and fun. So yeah, I hope you guys like it. Leave a like, leave a comment, leave a subscribe. We're gonna go into the movie review right in 1 second. Also, for the other people who want to know about the jacket, I'm putting a video out in like less than 48 hours, so don't even worry about that. I'm gonna put something at the end of the video so you guys go watch it. And yeah, this is already too long, so let's get into the review. Thank you guys. I love you guys. Thank you. Okay, let's go. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Clutch Cinema Talk. Yes, it's a. Things are looking different. Things are looking a lot different right now. This might definitely is not going to be the normal setup from now on. I just want to try something a little bit different. We're getting pretty different on this channel now. We're trying to upgrade some stuff right now. Looks a little bit different. I got my pink on for the movie I'm reviewing. But hey, look, just so you know, it's still movie vibes over here. All right, today we are going to be reviewing Barbie. Yes, we're finally doing Barbie. I got the pink on. I don't know what to call this guy. I don't know. Someone think of a name. I'm not gonna call it Pop or Popcorn. Come on, let's get creative. in most recent history, this Barbie and Oppenheimer, but definitely Barbie, it was one of the most hyped summer blockbusters in a while. People were really hype about this, and it was definitely the marketing combining Barbie with Oppenheimer, Barbenheimer. It was somewhat, it was a lot of fun, and Barbie, that's what it was. It was a super fun experience. I had an amazing time. There's no spoilers in this, as there's no spoilers in most of my reviews right now. I'm not sure if I want to change that up a bit, but there's no spoilers in this, so you don't gotta, don't worry. I mean, half you, 80%, 90% of you guys have seen this movie by the time this review comes out. I'm so late with it. It felt like if you took the Lego movie and you combined it with Elf, that was the kind of vibe going on with it. Basically, the plot is that Barbie ends up in the real world. That's the most basic plot description. It was very creative, and I love when movies, they just go all out on the source material and they just make it as wacky and as crazy as possible. I'm talking specifically about Barbie Land and how the creative elements they use to kind of poke fun at how people were using Barbies. And like, one example is how she you see in the trailer, this is in the trailer, so not a spoiler, how she comes down from the house, she floats down because someone would be carrying her down. Stuff like that is so fun, and it's like, wow, that is smart, and that they took time into that, and they made it a fun, creative way, and it's like, oh, yeah, June, I got that. It knew when to be serious, and it knew when to joke around, and things like that you can appreciate, because, for one, this is not a kid's movie. Let's just be 1,000% clear on this. It is not a kid's movie at all. So if you're expecting to, you know, bring your kids over there and have it like a nice little, your daughter's little clan, and you guys all gonna go see the Barbie, there may be some things you're gonna be like, whoa, let's bring it down a little bit. It's not a kid's movie, but it's still a great movie for adults, for sure. Great performances throughout. Margot Robbie and Ryan Gosling, listen, they, great chemistry, carried throughout. They'll have their individual performances that make up a humongous chunk of the film, and the supporting cast around them, there's so many different names that I don't even wanna again too, but everyone just did a great time, and they all look like they're having fun. That's one thing you want to see in a movie, where even though the actor is in character, everyone seemed like they were having a great time, and that just brings a sort of kind of warmth and what is comfortable, like the regular that just feeling comfy with the film. And I'm sweating. I don't know why I'm wearing a sweater. I couldn't find anything else pink right now. Oh my goodness, I am sweating. I don't want to get it on the popcorn, though. The movie definitely makes sure it gets the central message and theme across. And when I say they make sure with repetition, 1,000% a social commentary about things right now. I do believe some parts are a little bit exaggerated more than others. I'm like, damn, this sucks. Why can't this be that? You know, I'm just keep it as like very general as possible. But overall, this is a very interesting watch, especially if you watched, if you guys did the Barbenheimer like in one day, like Oppenheimer then Barbie or Barbie then Oppenheimer, oh my goodness, the whiplash is crazy. But at the same time, they're kind of similar in a way, but still vastly different. I really wish that, you know, imagine every summer there's some kind of like crazy mismatch that people be putting together. Like that would be fun. And I think that really brings cinema back to life, because, you know, since 2020 it's been kind of like meh. And now with this whole writer strike and actor strike, things are going to be a little bit rocky for the next few years. But this was fun. I didn't watch it back to back. It actually took like 2 weeks in between. Yeah, on Letterboxd, I believe I gave Barbie a 4.5. I don't know what side I'm putting it on. 4.5. I liked it a lot. I really like it. It had me inspired the whole time, and maybe that's why I gave it a little bit high. I don't know if I put it under 4. Now, if you guys are like, oh my god, you put it over Oppenheimer, listen, on my 2023 list, I do rank Oppenheimer higher than Barbie. Barbie, I have it toward the top, but not officially the top. I still think Oppenheimer's a better film overall. But Barbie, you have a lot more fun with. I think you could put it that way. So, yeah. Thank you, guys. We got this new setup. Things are changing here. You let me know what you guys thought about Barbie. What was your favorite parts? Who are your favorite characters? For sure. I know people, you're going to mix and match. And yeah, so I will see you guys in the next video. I don't know how to close this video out. You guys are so far away from the camera. I don't know if I should get up and go put my hand on it like I usually do. But no, I should. So I'll catch you guys in the next video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on those post notifications, baby. All right, guys. Catch you guys next time. You're...